everyone, and welcome to Wake County's Storytime Anytime. I'm Miss Grace, and I'm so glad that you're here with me today. All of our story times here are based off of Every Child Ready to Read's 5 pre-reading skills, and those are reading, writing, talking, singing, and playing, and we're going to practice some of those things today. We're also going to talk about a letter. It's right up here. Maybe you've know it, maybe you've seen it. It's the letter Z. It makes a Z, Z sound, like for zipper or zigzag or for a place where you go to see lots of different animals, like the zoo. So today our songs and stories are going to be about all the fun we can have with the animals at the zoo. And we're going to learn how to say the letter Z and zoo with our hands in sign language. To start with our letter Z, we're going to take our pointer finger and draw a Z. Then to say the word zoo, we draw our Z again and add some O's. So this is Z is for zoo. All right, and the first animal that we are going to be is a goldfish. So what do goldfish like to do? Does anybody know? That's right, they like to swim. Can you show me how you can swim your arms one at a time? All right, I think you're ready to be a goldfish.
Lots of little fish were sleeping on a rock in the bottom of the ocean. They lifted up their heads.
Good morning!
And they shook out their
tails. Can you shake out your fish tail?
And they said, let's go!
We're gonna go swimming! Can you go swimming?
Let's go swimming!
Swim all around.
Yeah, let's go swimming! Let's go swimming! Let's go swimming! In the bottom of the ocean.
Then the little fish got so very, very tired.
That was a lot of swimming. Good night.
They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up,
good morning!
They were a little bit dirty, so they took a shower.
Let's take a shower! Can you wash your hair?
Hair. And they washed their ears.
Don't forget your ears.
And they washed their tummy.
Can you wash your tummy?
And they washed their very long
fishy beards. And your beards.
And they washed their
nose.
Can
you wash your nose?
And they washed their toes.
What about your toes?
Came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up,
good morning!
They decided to ride their bicycles.
Oh, can you ride your bike? Can you hold on to the handlebars?
To the left.
We're gonna ride this way.
And they rode to the
and this way.
And they rode all day, yay! And they rode all night, 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 night. They rode down the hill.
Like to swim.
Let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming. Let's go swimming. Let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they
came
back to the rock. And they put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up,
good morning!
They decided to brush their teeth.
Oh, let's brush our teeth!
So
can you get your toothbrush?
Their toothbrush and their
and your toothpaste.
And they squeeze a little.
All right, get ready to bring your teeth.
I really like the taste.
And brush, brush, brush.
Put it in their mouth. They brush north and south.
And up and down.
And then they said,
Wait a minute. We're fish.
We don't brush our teeth. We go swimming!
Let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming. In the bottom of the ocean, let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming. In the bottom of the ocean.
Great job, everybody! Give yourselves a great big hand. We're gonna get ready for our first story. Let's make sure we've got our wiggles out. Can you show me your two hands? All right, my two hands go clap, clap, clap. And my two feet go tap, tap, tap. My two hands go thump, thump, thump. And my two feet go jump, jump, jump. My one body turns around. And then we quietly sit down. And our first story is Wild About Books by Judy Sierra. All right. It started the summer of 2002 when the Springfield librarian, Molly McGrew, by mistake drove her bookmobile into the zoo. Molly opened the door and she let down the stair, turned on the computer, and sat in her chair. At first, all the animals watched from a distance, but Molly could conquer the strongest resistance. By reading aloud from the good Dr. Seuss, she quickly attracted a mink and a moose, a wombat, an oryx, a lemur, a lynx, 8 elephant calves, and a family of skinks. In a flash, every beast in the zoo was stampeding to learn all about this new something called reading. Raccoons read alone, and baboons in their bunches, and llamas read dramas while eating their lunches. Hyenas shared jokes with red-bellied snakes, and they howled and they hissed till their funny bones ached. A tree kangaroo who adored Nancy Drew began solving mysteries right there at the zoo, such as why were the Bandicoot's books overdue? Gently, Molly taught lessons in treating books right, for the boa constrictor squeezed Crictor too tight, and baby bunnies mucked up Goodnight Moon with their paws, and giant termites devoured the Wizard of Oz. Oh, we have to take care of our books. And Bear's love of books was completely outrageous. They licked all of the pictures right off of the pages. Oh no. Tasmanian devils found books so exciting that they soon gave up fighting for writing. They made up adventures so thrilling and new that the others decided to be authors too. Pythons wrote with their tails, penguins wrote with their bills, and porcupines wrote with their very own quills. At the new insect zoo, bugs were scribbling haiku, and the scorpion gave each a stinging review. As the cheetah's new novel began to take shape, he read chapters each night to the Barbary ape. And although the gazelle couldn't spell very well, like everyone else, she had stories to tell. Imagine the hippo's enormous surprise when her memoir was given the Zoolitzer Prize. And with so many new books, Molly knew what to do. She hired 12 beavers, a stork and a gnu, to build a branch library there at the zoo. Then the animals cried, "We can do it ourselves. We can check the books out. We can put them on shelves." And they did, and they do, to this very day. 3 cheers for the Zoobrary. Hip, hip, hooray! When you visit the zoo now, you surely won't mind if the animals seem just a bit hard to find. They are snug in their niches, their nests, and their nooks, going wild, simply wild, about wonderful books. The end. That was lots of different animals we saw down at the zoo reading all sorts of books. That was so silly. We are gonna see some other animals at the zoo, and maybe we're gonna make some sounds to see if we can sound just like those animals. All right, we're gonna go to the zoo to visit. I went to the zoo to visit one day, and I saw an elephant along the way. What do you think I heard him say? Oh, did you hear that elephant? All right, I went to visit the zoo one day, and I saw a monkey along the way. What do you think I heard him say? Ooh, ooh, see if we can see some other animals. I went to visit the zoo one day. I saw a snake along the way. And what do you think I heard him say? What does a snake say? That's right. And we're gonna visit the zoo one more time. I went to visit the zoo one day and I saw a tiger along the way. And what do you think I heard him say? Roar! Can you roar like a tiger? Oh, great job. Okay, now we're gonna be a monkey again and you're gonna see if you can copy the moves that I do, okay? All right, monkey see, monkey do. Little monkey at the zoo, monkey, monkey in a tree. Can you clap your hands like me? Oh, nice clapping. Let's see what else we can do. Okay, monkey see, monkey do. Little monkey at the zoo, monkey, monkey in a tree. Can you stomp your feet like me? Great job. Monkey see, monkey do, little monkey at the zoo, monkey, monkey in a tree. Can you wave your arms like me? Ooh, ooh, ah, ah. Great job. Monkey see, monkey do, little monkey at the zoo, monkey, monkey in a tree. Can you peel your banana like me? And take a bite. Oh, excellent. Now we are gonna do some jumping. So let's do some practice jumps. Let's see, on the count of three. One, two, three, and jump. Excellent job. We're gonna do jumping and counting, so I think we're ready. Can you jump?
Jump, 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 jumping higher we, but we'll stop jumping while we count to three.
Oh, we're gonna stop and count. One, two, three. Great job! Let's jump some more!
Jump, 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 jumping even more. But we'll stop jumping while we count to four.
All right, we're gonna count again. One, two, three, four. All right, we're gonna jump some more.
Jump, 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 just like pogo sticks. But let's stop jumping while we count to six.
Oh, let's count to six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Wow, all six. Let's jump some more.
Jump, 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 jumping, then we wait to stop our jumping while we count to eight.
Oh, can you count to eight? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. We got all eight. Let's keep jumping.
Jump, 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 jumping once again. But we'll be finished once we count to 10.
Oh, we're gonna count to 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten! All ten!
And you can jump right back down into your seats.
Give yourselves a great big hand for jumping and counting with me. We're going to read another story. Let's make sure our wiggles are out. All right, show me your two hands. There we go. My two hands go clap, clap, clap. And my two feet go tap, tap, tap. My two hands go thump, thump, thump. And my two feet go jump, jump, jump. My one body turns around. And then we quietly sit down. All right, our next story is From Head to Toe by Eric Carle. And this has some more animals. Maybe you can do the things that they do. I am a penguin and I turn my head. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a giraffe and I bend my neck. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a buffalo and I raise my shoulders. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a monkey and I wave my arms. Can you do it? Oh, I know you can. We did it earlier. I can do it. I am a seal and I clap my hands. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a gorilla and I thump my chest. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a cat and I arch my back. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a crocodile and I wiggle my hips. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a camel and I bend my knees. Can you do it? I can do it. I am a donkey and I kick my legs. Can you do it? I can do it. I am an elephant and I stomp my foot. Can you do it? I can do it. I am I and I wiggle my toe. Can you do it? I can do it. I can do it. The end. All right. Well, seeing all of those animals at the zoo made me really, really want a pet. So I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet. And they sent me this package. So I'm gonna see if maybe they sent me a pet. Oh, I'm so excited. I wonder what it's gonna be. I wrote to the zoo and they sent me, whoa, what is this? It's an elephant. Oh, I love him, but he's too big. So I had to send him back. And then the zoo sent me, what did they send me next? Oh, they sent me a giraffe. Oh, he looks so soft, but he's too tall. So I sent him back. And then, guess what? The zoo sent me another pet. They sent me, oh, a lion. Roar! But he was too fierce, so I sent him back. And then they sent me, oh, what did they send me? It's a snake. Oh my goodness, he was too scary. I think I'm gonna have to send him back. And then the zoo, they sent me, what do you think they sent me? Oh, they sent me a monkey. I bet a monkey is a perfect pet. Oh, he looks so nice. Oh, but he was too naughty. I think I need to send him back. He should live at the zoo. I don't know if the zoo is a very good place to get a pet. Let's see what else they sent me. Oh, they sent me Ribbit. Oh, a frog. Oh, but he's too jumpy. Oh my goodness. I think I'm gonna have to send him back. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to have a pet. Oh, I think there's one more thing. Let's see. What did the zoo send me? Oh, they sent me a puppy. He's perfect. All right. He's gonna come home with me. That is a nice pet. I think all the other animals should stay at the zoo. Thank you so much for coming to play with me today and seeing all of our different animals and animal sounds. Let's see if you can practice those five pre-reading skills at home: reading, writing, talking, singing, and playing. And maybe you can find some animals around your neighborhood and pretend to be just like them. And my name is Miss Grace, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.